What if the quiet shadows in our rooms woke up with a mind like ours? Not just the instinct to hide, but strategy. Not just a flicker on the wall, but a plan you can't see. House spiders already thrive inside our homes. They feel our footsteps through the floorboards, read air currents like weather reports, and build traps from their own bodies. Give them human-level intelligence, and the house stops being just a building. It becomes a territory under new management. Let's start with their silk. To us, it's just threads and cobwebs. To an intelligent spider, silk becomes an entire toolkit. Different fibers already do different jobs: drag lines for safety, sticky spirals for capture, tough anchors for support. With a human-caliber mind, those roles turn into engineering. Webs get tuned like instruments. Tighter meshes near light sources where moths circle, and looser designs in dark hallways that act like tripwires. Dust isn't a nuisance anymore. It's camouflage. They'd weave lint into the edges to dull reflections that might scare off prey. The result is less like a web and more like a network, one that understands the building better than we do. Their senses would evolve into analysis. House spiders already perceive the world through vibration. Tiny tremors translate into maps. A phone buzzing on a desk, a fan thumping slightly off balance, your footsteps shifting from tile to rug. With intelligence, those vibrations form sentences. A spider learns your schedule by the rhythm of your movements. It marks the quiet hour when the kitchen lights go off and the fruit bowl becomes a magnet for flies. It remembers the rainy week when gnats rose from your overwatered plants. These patterns turn into forecasts. The spider doesn't just wait to get lucky. It sets its traps based on data. And then communication would change everything. Today, spiders mostly communicate with vibrations and scent. With a bigger mind, that becomes a language. Still silent, still subtle, but incredibly precise. A single pluck on a shared support thread could carry meaning. New food source near the window. Or, cleaning day is approaching. Avoid this area. In an old house with connected wood beams, entire colonies could share a backbone of signal lines, stitching apartments into a whispering grid. Knowledge would stop dying with the individual and start living in the house itself. From there, culture would emerge. A house style of web design would develop. Corner webs might have two slack lines for shock absorption. Webs by the front door might be slightly canted to compensate for the draft. The elders, females with proven, successful broods, would become the master architects. Juveniles would learn by practicing, building small test webs in safe spots before graduating to high traffic areas. Over months, your home would turn into a living atlas of best practices, updated each night while you sleep. This coexistence would stop being accidental. Many house spiders already hunt the pests we hate: flies, silverfish, roaches, mosquitoes. Intelligence would make that service deliberate. A colony would map your problem spots and position teams like surgical tools. A taut, triangular web over the fruit bowl. A low-slung sheet web along a damp basement wall. The results would feel almost eerie. Fewer insects, fewer bites, fewer things skittering in the dark, until you realize someone's running a quiet pest-control microgrid. Not with chemicals, but with intelligent design. For a small creature, power is all about placement. Intelligent spiders would practice invisibility as a core policy. Webs would shift just a centimeter to avoid the glare that might trigger a broom. Anchor lines would be hidden under moldings and behind picture frames where cleaning rarely reaches. And when a web must be visible, it's placed where its usefulness is obvious. Right where a mosquito buzzes around your lamp, or where fruit flies would otherwise swarm. They would know that you tolerate what benefits you, and they would build to earn their place. So, would they ever move against us? Rarely, and not out of spite. For them, risk is a math problem, and humans are a very bad risk. But you might notice subtle pressure if you threaten their network. Sweep the same corner every single night, and you'll find that corner stays empty. Instead, A new, more efficient web appears above the sink, where you actually need it. Seal a window gap completely, and the spiders might reroute air with diagonal lines that nudge drafts toward their other traps. You'd feel your home breathing differently without knowing why. It's not sabotage. It's optimization, managed by a landlord you never hired. Numbers matter. A single spider is a curiosity. A household of hundreds is a system. With intelligence, reproduction stops being random and becomes policy. Egg sacs would appear when the pantry is full of midsummer flies, not during lean winter months. Juveniles would disperse not randomly, but by design. One to the bathroom fan, one to the porch light, and a few to the basement shelves. If you bring home a new plant, teeming with fungus gnats, the network would expand overnight, like a company opening a new branch. They don't have hands or tools, but they have silk, patience, and geometry. And that's enough. Some might innovate, layering transparent trip lines across lampshades to slow down flying insects just enough for capture. Others might discover acoustic baiting, a faint plucking pattern that mimics a trapped insect, drawing others into sticky zones. Even other predators would learn the new rules. House centipedes that used to raid webs would now face decoy strands that trigger a second web to collapse on them like a net. Jumping spiders, their clever rivals, would be lured onto slack lines that turn their powerful leaps into harmless slides. And we humans would adapt, too. Instead of wiping out every web, you'd start performing triage. Useful web? Leave it. Messy web? Remove it. You'd develop unspoken house rules. Daunted to touch the high corner by the plant, that one stops the gnats. You might even start collaborating, moving a bowl of fruit a few inches to align with a known draft, or repotting a plant because the spiders signaled a gnat problem by suddenly building there. Sure, there might be a little fear at first, but fear fades when the benefits stack up. Fewer bites at night, fewer roaches. And as the webs become cleaner, more integrated with the lines of your room, your brain would stop reading mess and start reading pattern. It helps that the spiders would avoid spectacle. No dramatic dangling over your pillow. Intelligence knows the value of good public relations. The long view is what would make them unbeatable. Spiders live short lives, but their culture would erase that gap. Each season's best web placements, best thread tensions, and best hunting schedules would be preserved in the layout itself. The young would inherit a map woven yesterday and improved today. A 10-year-old house that used to breed pests would now devour them, guided by minds that never leave and memories that never fade. So what truly changes if house spiders gain human intelligence? It's not a horror movie. It's a negotiation. Your home starts offering a new kind of service in exchange for your patience and a few untouched corners. Webs stop being random and become infrastructure, and the quiet shapes in the shadows become something else entirely. Custodians who manage flows, measure risk, and keep the night from crawling in. Here's the real question. If a rival species offered to keep your home clean and pest-free in exchange for space and respect, would you say yes? Or would you cling to the idea that control means total emptiness? Maybe the smartest future is also the smallest one. Lines of silk you hardly see, holding back a tide you rarely notice. Run by neighbors who learned your schedule, earned your tolerance, and built a city inside your walls so you don't have to fight one outside them. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this thought experiment, be sure to like this video and subscribe for more ideas that make you see the world a little differently. See you next time.